Hey, we back. We're on challenge five now. We're still doing this. Yes, there's six challenges, and I've recently discovered that I was meant to test them properly, like properly, and comment them and coding style and oh no. So there's going to be some extra parts at the end where I do that. I did think I should probably go do it while it's fresh in my mind, but on the other hand, it's not fresh in my mind now anyway. So it'd be at least nice and organized if I did it at the end. So that's the plan. Anyway, I did kind of start challenge five because how do I say this? It's like number three again. It's kind of hard to understand. If you remember back to number three, if I just do this, yep, there we go. I kind of looked at all this. I didn't know what that was, like at all, really. Well, I kind of get it now, so that's good. And I just sort of stared at it for a while, and then accidentally did the whole thing. And it's the same with this. Number four was easy because that's just backwards of three. But then number five. You see, we take things like this and we're turning them into things like this, and I don't know about you, but that looks mighty weird. Where have all the extra variables come from? Why are there like abstractions everywhere and all the rest of it? And like, I don't know, it's just all long. I mean, this is so short compared to these, but it's longer than most of them anyway. How's this work, huh? So yeah, I kind of stared at this for another hour or so. You can kind of tell from this bit. This is kind of representing what's going on here. I don't really understand this, but this one is quite helpful. I kind of get this, so like I figure out, right, this is an abstraction, right? So this is an abstraction, but without E, it's just with the variable X applied to K. So if you look at this here, let's take this 2X for example, you've got this is so 5 becomes K, you've got the abstraction, and then you've got K again, and then E, right? There's E, so then you've got the abstraction with K, K again, and then E. That is another abstraction. The abstraction goes to E, kind of. Yeah, I still don't really get it to be honest. But it looks good, right? It looks like the sort of thing that this is. And if you notice the pattern, so this X2 becomes this with the X2 at the end. If you break it down, this X1, that's this bit here with the X1 at the end, and this X2 is this here with the X2 at the end, and so on, right? It's a nice pattern. And you can kind of use this for all of it. So what I've created is a little thing here to recognize the patterns. It's a transform expression, as we've got it at the moment, takes an expression and an integer, which I'll explain in a minute, and returns a pair of an expression and an integer. So, for example, if you give it a variable x, no, that's macro, skip that, a variable x, and here, so the integer that we're looking for here is basically the variable that we're currently at, which again I'll explain in a minute. You take an abstraction, you put the variable, application, the variable, and the variable x, and then you return var plus one. But if you break this down, you've got an application of a variable that I haven't explained yet, and the one that you were given, right? So if you then look at here, you've got an application of the variable that I haven't explained yet, and the one that you're given, right? And then you abstract this with that there. So you see, it's abstracted with this here. You notice this var here is the same as this var here, right? So it works. Now, here's where the problem arises with the integer. None of these are meant to be duplicated, right? So we don't know what to put here. You can't just say, okay, this is two, we'll put three here, because then what you put here? And especially with things like applications, you don't know how far you've gone along. So var is there to keep track of how far you've gone along, which is why it returns it, right? We return var each time, and then we can keep on going. So even if you pass it at a big chunk expression, it'll increase it. So this, look, it used one var, so it'll return var plus one. If you go in the application one, that's the complicated one, it uses a var there, var plus three here, var plus one there, var plus 2 here, so on. So at the end, it returns... So it shoves... this is the thing, you see we're using second here. So it returns var plus 3, and then whatever the return of this is, right? So this will return the current variable, and then we take second, right? So it passes it var plus 3, that's the one we're currently on, because var plus 3 is only used here in this, right? When we take, sorry, in this, we take the first of it, right? And then it's used here for second to figure out where we're currently at. And then we use it here. This whole thing there is just, that's just a number, right? Which you then pass into this again with expression 2. You take the second, and so then this whole thing here is also just a number. It was some complicated mathsy things, and you see the line is very long. We're at line 372, which is a new record. Yay! And, basically, it took a while just to get my head around, like, the bracketing and stuff, you know, how many pluses we need on the end of the var, and where is a lamap and a lamabs, and where do they all go. Things like this is easy, because it just puts a macro. This isn't too bad, you know. Even the abstraction is, I mean, it's a bit complicated, as you can see, but it's okay. But the lamap, oh, that took me so long just to write that one line. It's very annoying. But the upshot of this is that I can go over here and I can say, okay, transform expression, and I can give it, say, lamap, lambar 1, lambar 2, and remember we're still passing it this. This is something that I'll add in later. But you see, we've got 1, we've got 2, so we're now on 3, right? And it gives us this, right? But if you look here, this is this, right? I know it's kind of hard for you to see them both at the same time, but it is, okay? This here, especially since it's not pretty printed. Although, saying that, I can, of course, pretty print it. So, if we take that again, we're going to shove it in some brackets. Remember, this returns the variable that we're currently at, which is 8. Because, look, we've got 7s in here, but there's no 8s actually in here. So it returns a 7. Sorry, an 8, because there's no 8s. That would be the next one to use. But if we take first of that, which is going to be the actual expression... actually, I could have just skipped. Oh, no, I couldn't. Okay, forget that. And then I pretty print it. Because we do still have that function from the other one. yeah, no, that's fair, that's fair. We need to shove it in a lambda. There you go. Take however many. There we go. So now we have this with x3, the x6s, x1, x4, x7s, and this weird thing with the 4, 5, 3. That's all here. Right, that's this. And the thing at the end with the 4, 5, 3, it's all exactly the same. And it does that for all of these, which is fantastic. However, you have to split it up. I can't just pass it this right. I need to pass it this. And then put an argument on the end that says 2. Or I need to pass it this and put an argument on the end that says 1. Right, and if I do that, it'll work fine. But, yeah. In fact, I don't need to put an argument on the end that says 1. I need to put an argument on the end that says 4, because after you've abstracted this, you've already got 3 and 2 there. So, as you can see, not done yet. But it sure is getting there, right? We've got this. And then get var name here. This is another little function that I wrote actually before this one, just because I predicted that I would need it. Is just going to get the highest variable. So we can use this to plug into here, you see. So what I could have done over on these ones is if I take, say, this one, you're passing it 3. Instead of passing it 3, I could pass it get var name of, and then put that there, right? If I knew how to bracket properly anyway, Boop. There we go. And that's exactly the same thing, right? You haven't passed it the three this time. You've passed it to the same thing that you had already passed it there in the get var name thing. So that's one step on the way to making it a bit of a nicer function. And the way this basically works is it just traverses the whole expression tree thing and just takes the max of either the variable that you've got and the current one that you're working with. So obviously, you know, if you've got a macro, there is no variable here. It doesn't matter. You just return the one that you're at. If you've got a variable, you check, you know, is the variable that you're at now bigger than the one that you were going to use? So on. And obviously, for a Lambda expression, you recurse. Well, and for this, you recurse. It just figures out what's the biggest one. And then what this does is it passes it the initial value of zero. And then, of course, what this does is actually figure out what the largest variable is. You need to add one on to actually get it to use the right one, because otherwise you'd have a single duplicate, and that's not what we want. So there you go. That works fine. The point is, in this CPS transform thing, we're going to need to transform all the expressions individually. We're going to need to use this to find out the initial variable on each one. And obviously, we're going to need to use this as well because we have our macros to take into account too. So it's going to be great. It's going to be great. At any rate, that is today's job. Shoving all of these little bits together. And then five will be done after that, which is great. We can move on to six, and then after that we've got our commenting and stuff to do. Our testing, official testing, of course. We've tested it as we've gone anyway. But just in CMD, I apparently need to make a testing file, which is fine, we can do that. Yeah. I'm wondering for now if it would be possible just to write the whole rest of it in here, if I actually need to make another function. I think it would be smart to make another one that does the macros separately. So we could have, like, transform macros, right? Something like that. And then we can transform the expression on the end separately. So this is going to take a list of pairs of string and lam expression. It's also going to take an integer. Yeah, it's going to need to take the int, the same one as this. And then it will return, well, it will return this again, but I guess it was going to return a list of these, huh? Right? String, actually. No, I know what it will return. Something like this. That seems like the goodness there. And then we can have here, like, our macros. And then this is going to be var, the same as this one, right? So there we go. That's the start of it. That's kind of the explanation of what we're doing. And you can see with this how we've created this basically the same way. Yeah. Now, wait, this is going to be a list, right? I think what we want is that this is, I don't want this to be part of the list, right? Yeah, okay. Yeah, we can do something like that. Yeah, okay. Now, let's quickly shove on some music and get this started at least. I'm going to need to go actually pretty quickly. I was just going to do the explanation, maybe a little bit of coding. But soon enough, I will go. So just a few minutes, and then obviously for you I'll cut anyway. So you'll be all fine. Right then, let's see what we're actually doing with this then. So we've given it a macro, a string, and a lamb expression. So we will want a second of m, and shove that in brackets. So this is the macro that we're currently transforming. And then I can just shove on this as well, transform macros with the rest of the list. Right, and a var as well, but for now we'll just leave it as var, right? And we're going to need a base case, which is going to be when this is empty. Actually, we don't care about that. No, we totally do, because then we return this in var, and that's going to need to be in brackets. There we go. So there's our base case done. So, this currently is just an expression, right? We need to transform it. Right, which takes a lambda expression, which is what we got. And then this is going to return a lambda expression and an integer. I think what we should do is we should have a where, so it's not duplicating the same thing. And then what we can say is transformed macro is this, and then we can have the first of transformed macro, right? And then here, instead of var, what we do is second of transformed macro, and here we give it var. I forgot about the var. You do need to pass that again, so it knows which variable it's currently at. Then of course this is only the lambda expression, but we need the string as well. So again, we're going to shove this in brackets, and then here we're going to put first of n, comma. I might as well shove that in brackets just to be safe. Let's see what that does. Is it even going to compile? Probably not. It didn't. Of course it didn't. Ah, because it is not returning the integer. So shove that all in brackets, there we go, something like that, and then we need to return var, right? Yes. So we're going to take
we have a very serious problem.
Second.
My mom is currently online shopping, and I don't think she has honey installed.
First we break up. Wait, hang on, what's going on over here? I just realised something. Give me a sec. Alright, I'm back. So we're just doing the integer at the end, so we need to take second of the result of this. Right, because of course transform macros itself does return an integer. So this is the other thing we need. This is going to need to be first of that. Whereas this is going to need to be second of that. And then let's see if that does anything. Believe it or not, that actually worked, which astounds me. But let's give it a quick go, I guess. If I can find a good example to use. Here's the start of one anyway. Pop over here. So what we need is transform macros which is going to take a list like this one here. I'm going to add a second element to this just to make sure that that all works, which is going to be lambabs2 with lambar1, like that. And then remember, we start off with the thing is zero. You see what that does, right? See if this is transforming the macros for us. So we've got F. F abstracted to zero. Ah, yeah. No, that's a good point, actually. That's not quite what I was hoping for. Okay, let's try it with 3 then. Let's see if that's more what I was going for. Right, so we've got F, lambabs3. I'm just checking this against the notes. Wait, this isn't even the right one, that's why I'm getting confused. Okay, yeah, here we go. So, we have F, lambabs3. To lamap, lambar3, lambabs1, lambabs4, lambap4, lambar1. That is exactly the same thing as the example. Here's the big question though, did it do the second one as well? So G starts at 5, that actually makes a lot of sense. Congrats on that, because this used 4, right? But it didn't use 5, so it starts with 5. And then it should be the same as the F other than that. So lamap lambar 5, lambabs 2, lambabs 6, lamap lambar 6, lambar 2. Yes, that's actually correct. That's actually, yeah, it's correct. That's what I was hoping it would do. Which is great. So, that looks like we have ourselves a working transform macros. So now all I need to do is transform the macros as well as the expression at the same time. And what's it meant to be returning? What is it meant to be returning? Just that, right? Oh, yeah, I guess the hard bit is passing the integer from one to the other, but that shouldn't actually be too difficult. Yeah, that's good. Right, give me a sec, I'll be right back. Alright, we're back. For reasons, we're going to have to keep this really short, so let's hope we can get this done as soon as possible. We're in this here, we've got transform macros, we've got transform expression, we basically just need to shove them together. So this here is taking a lambda macro expression. I honestly have no idea how long this is going to take, so yeah, I really hope this is short. It might be really short though, which would be nice. I wouldn't be surprised if it is actually really short, so let's hope so, eh? So yeah, we've got our macros, we've got our expression, right? Then this is returning this, so I believe this is just going to be transform macros. We want the first item of transform macros, because we don't want the integer, we don't need the integer yet. And then we need to hand it the macros, which is these. And then for this, and the integer that we pass it, it's going to be 0 at the start. But then see, this is where we use the second of that, because here we're going to put transform expression, we hand it the expression, and instead of handing it 0, we hand it this second, because this is the variable that this spits out after it's finished, right? So hopefully this works. If this is actually the whole thing, then I will be very happy. Of course it's not. No, that is because this is also returning two things. So here we need a first. Normally, after doing that, we would then use a second somewhere else, but that will be the end. That will be all of it once that's run. That compiled. Wonderful. So now let's try something. Let's CPS transform, and we give it a lambda macro expression. So let me go fetch an example. Well, here we go. Ah, yeah, these examples are in the source syntax rather than values of lambda macro expression. That's kind of annoying, actually. But I think I know what we can do, because if you remember, we have our parse lambda macro. So let me just test that this works. No, that's because of these. Okay, now try. There we go. There we go. How'd you get it out the just value though? I'm honestly not sure about that. Let me just give it a quick Google. I'm sure there's a function for it. Oh, we can just use from just. It says don't do that, but it's fine, we'll do that. Because we know that there's no error here. I mean, if nothing else, we just run it. We just ran it and it there was no error, so. Oh, dear. Did I spell it wrong or something? No. It's a hackage thing. Oh, is it? Wait, no. Yeah, no, it totally isn't.
Before using UpLearner, I was stuck on C's in all my subjects, especially psychology and economics.
This says it's not in it. We'll just mock up our own one then, I guess. Actually, we totally don't need to. I can just take this one. What am I doing? We just take that one. Look, it's fine. It's fine. We don't need it. It's fine. Right, CPS. Transform. That's not correct. Transform. We'll just give it that. Right then, let's see if that's correct. We should pretty print it. So it's a bit more readable. What? Oh dear. There we go, we got it working. Right. So, let's see if that is the example that we wanted. So, it should be def f, yeah. X3 to 3, we did 0 to 0, but that's fine, it's the same thing. Wait, no it's not, it's totally not, it shouldn't be 0 to 0. Ah, yes, now I know what my mistake is. It's because here we pass it 0, I've forgotten to use this up here that I did at the start. Hey? this only gets it from one... Ah, we're actually going to need an extra function here. I knew it wouldn't be so simple, because this gets it from one expression. We're going to need to make one that gets it from all expressions. Total var name, which is going to take a macro expression, return an int, oh wait, we're going to need one to do all the macros first though, aren't we, and that's going to need to be recursive, oh dear, get macros var name, which is going to take the macros, return an int, that's the base case, then here get var name, and we're going to hand that second of m. Right, now we want to run max on that and get macros var name on m's. Right, then here lambda, this is going to need to be in brackets, macros expression, get macros var name, macros, you're going to need max again, and get var name with the expression. Right. Now let's just test that quickly. Does it compile? No. Why not? It has something to do with this, apparently. He doesn't like this. Oh, yeah, no, I see why. My bad. Okay, that worked. Right, so now let's just do get total var name, pass it. No, not that. Where's my thick ass lambda expression? There it is. Gave it 3. That is correct. Fantastic. I will assume that works, because to be honest, I have already tested this a bunch. And this is just a recursive this, and this is just this combined with this again. So I don't really see how it could go wrong. Famous last words, I'm sure, but let's go with it. So now instead of here, what we want to run is get total var name, and we just pass that this whole thing. Alright. Does that work? Yep. So now, if I run this one again, here we go. Here we go. So what have we got now? X3, X3. X1, X4, X4, X1, in. X2, X... It's not quite there. These are meant to be X5. So it's not quite there. Ah! Ah! It is simply because this is 0 again. And yeah, it's not meant to be 0, is it? It's meant to be this. Okay. Reload. Yeah, that worked. Another try. X3 to X3, X1 to X4 to X4, X1 in, X5 to X5, X2. Oh, yes, that is the correct one. Now let's try another one. Wait, no, that's not what I want. I just want this. X1... No, I don't even want that. I just want X1, X2. Okay. Yeah, there we go. So now I'm going to take this. Pretty print. CPS. Transform. That. Oh, I've miswritten something somewhere. Oh yeah, because it's not meant to have the just. Forgot to actually remove it. That was the whole point of doing them separately. There we go. Okay. Is this what we wanted as well? X3 to X6 to X6 X1 X4 to X7 to X7 X2 X5 to X4, X5, X3. Yes! Okay, last one. We give it this. We give it that. Then, we take this without the just this time. We shove that in there. Okay, def F. X2 to X2, X1 to X3 to X3, X1 in X4 to to F. X5 to F, X6 to X5, X6, X4. That is perfect. Again, I was just using this. You see the tests here. I put in this, we get out this. In other words, it works. The reason I was doing the pretty printed is because of written as source syntax rather than a macro expression. So you would pass them and then put it back, but like I say, you need to get out the just, so it's kind of confusing. But yes, basically, it works fine, which is great. Given that, we are all done. We are finished. So, I guess, on to, number 6, next time. Yep. Alright then. Bye!